Growling Bear's vision. Now he sought to understand it. New prophets came with new visions. Loved by the Buffalo listened in hope.
Children, brothers from all the nation, you listen now. I have been to the white man's heaven. I have seen the white man's God. And he say to me, one day a great spirit will come, bring back the buffalo and all dead Indians. Will come back and live again. When this day comes, there will be no more sickness. All Indians will be strong, like young men. Be young again. White people cannot hurt Indians then. Do not tell the white people this. Follow my words. Go back to your people. Tell them to love one another. Do not fight. Do not steal. Do not lie. God show me a dance. A dance to take to my people. Go home. Make this dance. All Indians dancing. Good times will come.
Years had passed since Robert and Clara had left Pennsylvania. Robert had seen the land's promise turn bitter, but he was determined to carry on the best way he knew how.
Yeah, the feral scaffolds are outlawed now. A lot of things have changed since they split up the reservation last year. And now you got pockets of white settlers all over.
I imagine it's so different.
10 years is a long time, George. Stand aside, please.
You give something.
These rations are property of the U.S. government. I'm just the man who delivers them.
Government have no stomach.
You're gonna have to get your rations from Agent Royer.
Royer.
I'm sorry for your plight, but there's nothing I can do. Now, please, stand aside.
When your children cry for food, you will do nothing?
Your rations or not. Pay attention. Next.
No distribution till the line is straight. Can't you people understand what straight means? Next.
Makumasa.
What's the news, Wheeler?
Oh, you're the reporters. Tell me.
Looks like he's got nothing for us, as usual.
Well, I'm sorry to disappoint your ears.
You'd think, with all the hauling you do between here and Standing Rock, you'd see at least one young buck on the warpath.
You know, you boys could stand to get out of the agency for a spell. Why don't you talk to George? He just arrived here on the overnight out of New York City. I'm sure he'd be happy to share his impressions.
Next!
Royer around?
You know he never shows his face on issue day. Next! Only coffee, flour, and blanket this month.
No meat?
No meat, no sugar. Flour, coffee, blanket. Next.
I want bacon. Children very sick. We need food.
Bacon is meat. Next. Ingrates. You lean back on us here, Wheeler?
Why, I want to talk to Royer. A little business matter.
Next.
No long hair. No more than one wife. No heathenish ways. No old religion. No drinking. No language but English. If you can accept these things and step over there and pick up your uniforms.
We didn't get any now. Indian police are doing well.
Well, can't blame them for wanting something better, I suppose. Things took a bad turn back in 88. Crops failed, 2 years running. And the Indians weren't the only ones who suffered. We were damn near wiped out. But Clara, the boy, and me, we saw ourselves through. She can't wait to see you.
To see a world in a grain of sand, and heaven in a wild flower. Hold infinity in the palm of your hand, and eternity in an hour. Isn't that a wonderful thought? To see a world in a grain of sand. How many times do we look without seeing? Poetry teaches us to see things in a different way. And there's no reason to be afraid of it. Who wants to try? Read among yourselves, quietly. What a dapper Eastern gentleman you've become.
It's good to see you, Miss Clara.
Don't be so formal. It's just plain Clara now.
Yes, ma'am. I believe I'll let you two get reacquainted. I've got some business with Royer.
Come, my pupils. Class, I want you to meet George Voices That Carry. George was a student of mine a long time ago. He used to live here in Pine Ridge. Now he's come back, I hope, to teach.
No, not to teach. To learn. I lived among the white men for many years. But I am still Lakota, like you. And there is much to learn from our people.
Congress sets the policy, Mr. Wheeler. I am merely charged with carrying out its intent. The beef allotment to this agency has been reduced by 1 million pounds. Washington takes its census numbers quite seriously.
Well, it seems pretty damn short-sighted if you ask me.
And what about this bill of lading?
Couldn't bring myself to refuse them. They were starving. I'll pay for the lost goods in full.
Your charity only exacerbates a difficult situation, Mr. Wheeler. You may want to have a look at this. My colleague at Standing Rock, Mr. McLaughlin, informs me that rumors of an Indian messiah are spreading like wildfire. He reassures me it is only a minor annoyance, but I have my doubts.
Oh, no telling where desperate people will find hope.
I can only do so much, Mr. Wheeler. More than that, I am not allowed.
These people are suspicious of any changes. Your predecessor, Colonel Gallagher, was a hard man, but fair. They'd come to respect him.
Be that as it may, the new administration has selected me to see to its affairs.
Well, maybe when you've been here a little longer.
As you say. Is there anything else you wish to discuss?
No. No, I figure we're through.
I'll say good day, then.
Let's go, people. Keep it moving.
Okay,
looking for Red Lance. Son of White Crow. Grandson of Running Fox.
Tuawo hukize luta olehu.
Mkakike. Hoka hoke.
Hoka hoke. Hoka hoke. Little brother, look at you. They drink your blood, turn into Washichu. The Washichu did not defeat us. It was the wind and the snow of the grandmother's land that was our enemy.
And our father and grandfather? I'm sorry, brother. Truly.
Sitting Bull was the last to give up his rifle and horse. The Long Knives, they promised us land, but they lied. They made us prisoners.
All of you?
2 years the soldiers watched over our teepees. And then the Long Hair came and took us. And Buffalo Bill. He said he would pay us to be Indians. He showed us how to make faces and shake our tomahawks around.
I've come to stay, brother.
This is good.
Wanikiiki, Tepachutaki, Washakilo. Akotaha, Otatita Kuye, Wawicha Blakapelo.
Wachipikile Lila, Wawashi Chinktelo.
Waniki Yaki Wasichuo, Wichonkisa Picta Kea Hoa.
Hia, Ie Handuki, Wasichuki, Iayapi Ketelo.
Wachipikio Yateki, Unspewa Chaki Yapitelo.
Wawoka chiapiki, tawoi hamlaki. Wawicha yalahuo.
Aperpiki, wawicha walayalo.
Cloud could stop this nonsense with a word, but the old codger says it's nothing to do with him.
As I understand the dogma, sir, it shares many of our own Christian principles. A harmless version of their outlawed sun dance.
Looks more like a war dance to me. And you, Mr. Wheeler, you consider this demonstration harmless?
For that.
Thank you to stay out of government business, Mr. Wheeler.
This obscene display will cease immediately.
This prayer, white people pray, go heaven. We go heaven too.
You will stop dancing and disperse.
Kosh,
Kalaka Lakota. Koichape. Echiape. Kata Taka.
My way.
Take this down, Mr. Duffy.
Make it fast, Lane.
To the editor, New York Herald. The long-awaited violence here finally exploded today when a band of armed hostiles confronted the government's agent. Against impossible odds, Agent Royer acquitted himself without bloodshed and brought a well-deserved end to the pagan spectacle known as the Ghost Dance. It is common knowledge in these parts that the Sioux never dances. Foul dance except for one purpose, and that is war.
Jedediah.
You're him.
I reckon I am.
Welcome.
You know, a man gets to a certain age, he wants to be close to those folks that mean something to him. What family we have left is, they're still in these parts. But it has all changed so much. You know, makes you wonder what it's going to be like 100 years from now. I'm bigger and faster. I'm better, I suppose.
Don't know about better.
Sir, do I look anything like Jedediah Smith?
Well, there's only one Jedediah Smith, son. But, let's have a look. See here. Well, if you put on a few pounds and a few score years and rounded it off with a beard, I'd say, nope, nothing like him.
And dream of Margaret Lightshines.
And you've had no word of her?
No. Not a day goes by that I don't wish I could see my children again.
If she's on the reservation, Robert will find her.
You can count on it.
Closer together now, fellas. That's it. All you bucks, give me a ferocious look. That's good. All right, now, Sergeant, take the rifle off the chief and hold it up. A little higher. There it is. Hold still now.
Intrepid Pine Ridge Police Sergeant's Old Coyote and Yellow Earring apprehend renegade hostiles on the warpath with Custer's own rifles.
Yeah, that's good.
One, two, three. Huh? That was... Drink up, gentlemen. Thank you so much. They are going to eat this up in New York.
You got permission for that?
Got permission. Ask Royer. Might have seen her yourself.
Don't keep track of faces.
You let the fire go out.
Didn't notice.
What good are all these white man's books if you don't know when you're cold?
It's not that cold.
Read all these books?
There's much to learn from them.
What good is this knowledge?
You have many questions, Herr Lance, but you have no desire to hear my answers.
And you do not wish to learn.
I've told you. The ghost dance is only superstition. Spirits can't help our people. Only we can do that for ourselves.
You do not have ears. You will not listen.
Whoa, chie, kile chicha upalo. Pete waji wa chichu kihe ha. Tehki hunko apik desnielo. Wanahi kini pektelo.
Tohane wi chasha. Wanji te andash kini. Oki hishne yelo. Kawak pamani ekta. Pihinska, ilahanska. Iwachipi kile inanjin yapikte keyelo.
Mila haska ki duenik sui yink teshnielo. Waniki eki, woe amble wan makuelo. Ogle kile wawasha ke yuhayele. Mila haska tchmaza su inanji ink telo. Machpia luta na si tanka tchoe tepi. Kiwichipala. Tatanka, Uyotaka. Toya teki, Kowichipik te, Hecha yellow.
Cotton will not stop a lead bullet, no matter what Kicking Bear says.
To say, believe, or do not believe, this is the white man's way. Chiwi Chaki Apo.
Pernicious item, gentlemen, is known as a ghost shirt. Among its many powers, it is alleged to stop bullets. So let us not deny further that trouble is imminent. Every one of these hostiles is prepared to use violence. I have been among them before.
Question is, what are you going to do about it?
We can do nothing until the Interior Department and the War Department provide explicit instructions. Until then, we must all wait and be on our guard at the first sign of outbreak.
You just leave it alone? And likely as not, the whole craze will just die down on its own.
Mr. McLaughlin at Standing Rock believes that as long as a single malcontent like Sitting Bull remains at large, that we cannot be secure. And I concur. If you lock up the ringleaders,
then you're gonna have a real problem on your hands. Not just in your imagination.
Ghost shirt?
What will you take for it? You and me. We make trade.
Trade?
That's right. You want my camera?
What's a squaw know about taking pictures?
I'll tell you what. I'll give you $2 American. No can do. It's not for sale.
Hey, another camera is easy to come by. Where in the hell else are you going to find another ghost ship?
Lady, you got yourself a deal. How about that?
That's nice. Real nice.
I'm bulletproof.
You better not try it.
See to it.
Look at that.
I'll be doggone. I'm gonna go back to the barn and get some extra wire and tools and whatnot, and we'll fix her.
They busted in. Won't they just bust out again?
I don't think so.
Well, why not?
Maybe because this is the land they remember.
Oh!
makes my heart glad to see you with these children. You are a good mother to them. As you were to me.
My wandering must have cost you great worry and pain. Forgive me.
You were always our family's secret. But the road you have chosen has not been easy.
There were so many times when I thought it was impossible to go on. But I remembered your strength. How you carried on even after we thought Father had died. That was the greatest gift you gave to me. You helped me to endure. To live. When you're ready, you look through here. Then you press this button.
I'm happy you still take pictures.
I didn't. After Sand Creek. But it is all different now.
As you call it, is dying out? Well, I have put up with quite enough of this lunacy, and I intend to do something about it. Duffy, take this down. To the Commissioner of Indian Affairs in Washington. Wild Indians are dancing and cannot be induced to stop. The ghost dance has now assumed such proportions, both in the number and the spirit of adherents, that it is entirely beyond the control of the agent and the police force, who are openly defied by the dancers. The employees and the government property of this agency has no protection, and we are at the mercy of these dancers. We need protection, and we need it now. This agent suggests sending a body of troops sufficient to arrest the leaders therein and imprison them and disarm the balance of the reservation. Nothing short of 1,000 troops backed by the proper artillery will stop the proliferation of this diabolical dance.
God bless the boy. Colonel Forsythe.
We are friends of the agent. We are friends of the soldiers. The great father's friends are my friends too. I want not any trouble for my people. We have no guns to fight with. We have nothing to eat. We are too poor to do anything.
You are not too poor to dance your ghost dance.
Many say I have been to this dance. That is not right. My eyes are sore. They do not see very well. But when they better, I go and see it.
We do not ask you to see it. We ask you to stop it.
When winter comes, dancing stops. There will be no problems.
Many of your people have taken to the Badlands. If they do not return, we'll have no choice than to consider them hostile.
They think the soldiers have come to kill us. I not believe this, but they are afraid for their families. You understand.
And the warriors with them? Was to keep them from joining up with Kicking Bear and the other renegades.
That is all I have to say about this question.
The belligerent old scout taker harangued his listeners with a brazen speech in which imminent hostilities were threatened. The army can do nothing until the murdering Redskins have broken out and the young bucks have burned a dozen ranches and slaughtered a score of women
General
and children.
General Miles' orders are quite specific. We're to offer protection and maintain control and discipline.
So we're all just expected to sit here?
In the meantime, you're directed not to force any issue that might result in an outbreak. Discretion, Mr. Royer. If you and the other civilian authorities had demonstrated as much, the 7th would not be here now to enforce order.
Sitting Bull's headed this way to join the renegades in the Badlands. We'll be ready for them.
I caution you against any supply trips through Standing Rock in the next few days, Mr. Wheeler.
Why's that?
General Miles has authorized Sitting Bull's arrest.
Wouldn't it be better to wait till ration day? The fewer of his people around, the less cause there will be for disagreement.
Sitting Bull's actions require his immediate apprehension.
Could be just rumor. Whatever the people of the press are telling.
I provide you this information with regard to your own safety, Mr. Wheeler. What you wish to do with it is not my concern.
Take it.
I can't.
You are false to your people if you do not wear the ghost shirt.
This way is the way to death, Red Lance. Maybe we can find our own road. Maybe we can find our own destiny again. What are you doing?
You have too many Washitu ways. You even think like a Washitu.
You played the savage for money, Red Lance, not me!
Come on.
Indian police.
Hi!
You are my prisoner. You must go to the agency.
From a few miners' skirmishes, most of the fugitives have been persuaded to return peaceably. Hunger can be a powerful inducement to surrender.
You've still got thousands holed up in the Badlands, and no telling how many of Sitting Bull's people racing to meet them.
Our principal concern is Chief Bigfoot. Abandoned his camp on the Cheyenne River several days ago. Lieutenant Colonel Sumner intercepted him and demanded his immediate return. Bigfoot promised to do so, but during the night he slipped away.
Where is he now?
We think he intends to join the rebels in their Badlands stronghold. I await word from our scouting parties.
A very merry Christmas indeed.
He's wanted for the murder of an Indian policeman.
You don't know the circumstances.
Clara, the circumstances don't matter. If they catch him, they'll shoot him.
Surely you're exaggerating.
Have you seen what these so-called reporters are writing? The murderous Redskins are now whetting their knives in anticipation of the moment when they begin their bloody work.
Anybody with eyes in their head can see the agency's peaceful.
If George did kill somebody, he did it with provocation. We'll say a prayer for him.
He has the protection of Tatanka. That is no.
Tokia, Tahaya Hihu, Mawoyspe, Tataka Yotaka Kdepi, Taho Hippelo.
Tataka
Yotaka, Yomsla. Wazia haha, a wakpa minita miak pictelo. Mak pia luta, unkia pictelo.
Mila haska ole otama unya kapelo.
Mila haska upi kiob, wonglaka pictelo. Chaki zapi wanichielo.
Who I once was, Grandfather.
None of us are who we were. It is enough that you have returned to your people.
I killed a man. Another Washichu. Another Lakota.
I saw a darkness inside of you. Now I understand.
Lost my center. The world has lost its center.
For your Christmas present?
Parley with you. It's either unconditional surrender or fight. What is your answer?
No fight.
Where were you headed?
Pine Ridge. Make peace.
You lied to our troops once before. Why should we believe you now?
No lie.
I'm glad to find you peaceable. You and your people will follow us back to our camp. We'll provide blankets, rations. I'll have an ambulance sent forward. You'll ride more comfortably.
I guess I'm sick today.
How far is the camp?
5 miles. Creek call Wounded Knee.
Can't feed 400 people on this.
Your job is to deliver the required rations to Wounded Knee, Mr. Wheeler, not to question the order.
I'm not questioning, I'm just saying.
Don't fail to bring back your key eyewitness observations.
Won't you climb aboard and see for yourself?
Thanks, Wheeler, but I'm forced to remain in the thick of activity.
Style yourselves war correspondents. The only fighting you've seen is at the bar at the Hills Gate Hotel where you lubricate your vivid imaginations.
Hey!
Hey! Pine Ridge, South Dakota. Sunday, December 28th. The Indian war here has collapsed. Chief Bigfoot's defeated hostiles rest fewer than 30 miles from this agency, apprehended by the gallant men of the famed 7th Cavalry. The chief's surrender is all but certain to flush out those bands of renegades which, for too long, have held this agency and its surrounding settlements in a virtual state of siege. All civilized people here await Bigfoot's return and give thanks in this time of peace that the Indian troubles are about to be brought to a close without further sacrifice of life.
Keep you warm. Army regulation, wool underwear.
And this good medicine.
The best. Here, take a pair for yourself. Go on, take them.
He cannot hear.
They say some of Sitting Bull's people are here with you. I'm looking for a friend of mine. He's young, speaks English. His name's Voices That Carry. Hoka Hoke.
Richasha Kiles, Sloayelo.
Possible to bridge the Indian's world and the white man's world?
You are that bridge, George.
No. When I was back east, people looked at me as an educated Indian. Something different. A curiosity. I see that now. I lived among the white men, but I never belonged.
And you belong here?
I belong nowhere. This is what I've learned. This has been my real education. I am grateful to you for everything you've done for me, my friend. George.
Goodbye.
wants your men to fetch yourself up to Bigfoot's tent. Parley. You savvy? Come on, get. Parley.
Это кашня.
Словашне.
Какой чуд? Глупый тамбур.
Before taking your people to Pine Ridge, we must ask that you surrender any arms in your possession. Those with guns or rifles may now step forward, one by one, and lay down their weapons. Surely this cannot be all of them.
No more guns.
Have I not put you in an ambulance and had my doctor look after you? Did I not put you in a good tent with a stove to make you warm and comfortable? Did I not feed your people? Yet now, Bigfoot repays my kindness with lying?
No more guns.
Very well. Sergeant!
Sir!
You and your men search the village, teepee by teepee. Troop!
Detail!
Circle finish. And sit down.
That's a lot of it, sir.
I was led to believe this band was better armed.
Lieutenant.
kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation.
What is she saying?
She said they told her if she put on the dress, the bullets would not go through.
Why would anyone shoot women and children?
Shrapnel wound. She'll pull through. But I can't speak for the leg. Here, keep that tight.
You are all to return to your homes immediately and stay there. Until the situation at Wounded Knee in the Badlands is fully resolved, this agency is under martial law. Anyone violating the curfew or found holding a meeting will be arrested on site.
Can you tell us what happened out there?
Well, reports from the field are still coming in, but as best as I can ascertain, the Indians fired first.
Thank you.
What the hell you think you're doing? Them's worth $2 apiece. Back off now. You hear me, Chief?
Leave him alone! Can't you see he's a holy man performing the death rite? You do, eh?
You're done. I'm much happy.
You know why you keep working on Dr. Chante, when eh?
That day, I saw Growling Bear's vision come to pass. Chantemashiche, my heart was sad, but our people still live. We live, and so we have hope.
Well, that's the story as I know how to tell it. You know, somebody else might tell it a little differently. You see, the only history the man knows for certain is that small part he owns for himself. We can't forget we're all part of the same wheel, the hubs and the spokes and the fellas. You break one, and you break the wheel.
When you tell your stories, you touch the grandmothers and grandfathers, the Nihukapikiko, and all the ancestors who walk before them. And when others ask you where you know these things, tell them. Te Yotalapi, loved by the buffalo, was spared so I can tell you this story.
I want you to remember these stories, Jedediah. So when your time comes, you can pass them on. It's important for people to know where they came from and what others have been through. I always told my children, I said, you are one part Virginia and one part Lakota. Be proud of both.
Now, this story belongs to you.